Hello, hello, and welcome once again. J76NY here, and I am back from the dead, for the most part. I'm about 60% better. Whatever it was really laid me out, so thank you very much for your support on the post that I put up, and for your patience in the lack of content this week. Guess it was better to happen last weekend than upcoming weekend, which is Christmas, so... But we are going to move on with our ABDACOM campaign. I believe this is episode number 12, and we've got a whole slew of Japanese activity right around Surabaya. We've got this cruiser group, which is, I think this is the undamaged group. This says submarines, but it's the other cruiser group. Close proximity to Task Force 2, which is on their way down to deal with them, I believe. It's been a while since I played this game, so my plans from the last episode may not exactly match up with what I'm doing right here. Anyway, let's get some planes up to maybe deal with these guys if we have anyone, which we don't. We got this guy. We can get him up in spot and just do that and go right to tactical. See if we can see what he is. I think he'd be pretty easy to spot in this little channel here, but... apparently not. Unless he's a little further north. But he's not really all that important, so we'll send him back. And you can return to base. Actually, I probably should have just used you as a scout. What to do about you? We don't have any... planes available here. We do have a couple of the biplane torpedo bombers, but they don't have the range, 158 nautical miles. So that is just outside of the range. I'm not going to launch them until I have something that I know they can actually make it to. We do have the Trusty, which is still heading down to pick up some more torpedoes here at Surabaya. We did spot that fleet carrier with the Congo class after they dropped off their supplies at Singapore. We're still holding on at Singapore, which is kind of surprising. S5, I think we're going to pull you out just a little bit. Kind of have you stay up in this area like this. And then Truant. Have you kind of angle a little more into position like that to intercept them if they start heading in this direction. These two supply convoys are going to have to alter their course. So we'll have them come up through here. I was sending Task Force 1 up to reinforce up here, but then we retook it, so they can go somewhere else. Try and avoid this area for the time being until we can deal with some of these threats. Now, just off of Darwin, we do have the Exeter being escorted by the Marblehead and the Paul Jones. I've been told, and I did look it up, that the Marblehead has one hell of a story about I believe it was 20,000-mile journey back home with a ship that they could not steer after they took a lot of damage. It's a good story. If you want to look it up, just Google the Marblehead's journey home, and you're going to find yourself in awe of what this crew did, especially with a ship like this. But it was pointed out that these are two very slow ships, so we're going to split them off from Exeter. We're going to get Exeter heading up on her own to join up with Task Force 1. These two destroyers are going to join up with the supply convoy at some point and offer anti-submarine capabilities to them. And other than that, we're just going to let the game play out as it does and see what happens. All right, we are with Task Force 2. They were intercepted by that small group that said it was submarines, so it very well may be submarines. It may not. Not seeing anything just yet. There it is, right there. Okay. So we are going to break our ships. And speed you up here. Houston. In a turn, we're just going to have Sumatra kind of run straight. Maybe alter course just a little bit. You. Have you turn up and head in. Yara, do the same. Java. Hopefully we can get Java and Sumatra out of here. Looks okay for Sumatra. Should be okay. Java might be another story. So let's head Swan up. Looks like Houston's doing okay as long as she doesn't run into her destroyer friend here, which she very well may. You can just come to a stop. Java. I'm not seeing the torpedoes. Looks like may have passed just astern of us. So we got lucky there. Okay, you can come to a stop now. Sumatra and Java both have depth charges. But we're going to let our destroyers take the lead on this one. Okay. If you head off in this direction. Swan is damaged. Alright, let's cut our speed a little bit. Here. See if we can't pick up that submarine. Not seeing any subs. Even cheating like that. Yeah, let's bring you down a little slower. I'm kind of glad it was just a submarine, to be honest with you. Wouldn't really want to tangle with a surface group right now. The other surface group that we did spot with the Kingfisher was the undamaged cruiser group. So the damaged cruiser group is heading in an easterly direction away from us. Unfortunately, they're heading right for our supply convoy. So where would our submarine friend be? Swan's doing circles. I think we may have lost him, unfortunately. Have Swan slow down a little bit. He should be up in this area here, I would think. Have you come back like this? Searching a pattern like that. Let's have you come out and around. So we'll look around for a little bit and I'll get back to you if I actually find him. Yeah, I looked around, couldn't find him, so we're gonna call that one. So we've got the undamaged cruiser group up here. We've got submarines in the area here. Task Force 2 is heading in this direction now. The other cruiser group, the undamaged one, or the damaged one, was heading out in this area. We're going to see what we can find with them. All right, back with Task Force 2 once again. We did shoot down a float plane. Got the countdown timer going, and before we could leave, we got torpedoes in the water, so they're hitting us again with this fairly persistent submarine. So we're going to do some maneuvers, and we're just going to continue straight. I'd like to deal with this submarine. Get it taken care of. First and foremost, I want to get my cruisers out of harm's way. As best I can here. Like, they only launched two torpedoes this time. Sumatra, let's have you break and kind of straighten out and try and run in between them. Oh, this is going to be bad. This could be bad. Alright, now you're going to slow down. Because if they pop up on our sonar, you're going to be first in line to attack them. Okay, looks like Houston got out okay. Java's fine. Warrego. Swan's doing the best she can. Houston, you can slow down too. Java, slowing down. Alright, Swan's just gonna miss. Really wish Sumatra had sonar. Actually bring these guys to a stop and see if we can pick them up from out there for do some spotting for Sumatra. Oh, there we are. Right down there. I think it's going to be doing some spotting for Java. Alright, we'll have Sumatra kind of heading this direction down here. Let's get Java in. Now we lost her. Slow down again. There she is. Everyone capable of attacking with depth charges. Targeting her. Set you up, Java. 20 out of 20, we're going to go with 5. It's only at 33 feet, too. Okay, pick up your speed a little bit. Burn it in. Kind of strange that she's still sitting at 33 feet. There she is. Hello. looks like Java's coming in at a pretty good angle. She's maneuvering, but I think we can keep up with her. Catch up with her a little bit. If we lose her, we can just slow. There we go. Kind of expecting that, but I want to go 31, that's for sure. I just wanted to catch up a little quicker here. That's her right there. If we're not careful, we're going to ram her. Start swinging your stern over her. Looking good. Slow down slightly. Rudder amidship. There she is, right there. A lot of leeway here. Pretty interesting. Doesn't look like she's maneuvering at all. Slow down a little more. Drop. Do I have anywhere to go? Sinking right to the bottom. There we go. Okay. One sub down. Good job, Java. All right, so we do have this up here now. Five ships. S4 is moving up to intercept. I guess we'll see which direction they go. Heading in the, oh shit. Not exactly who I want to tangle with. This could go bad. We are going to run away. Trusty, unfortunately, has no ammo, no torpedoes or anything. They may catch us. Oh, wait. Ah! Woo! Look at that. That was a close call. Okay. Rusty. Rearm. All ships rearmed. Thank you. Rusty, how you doing? 18 torpedoes. Cause some problems. Ruint, come help out. Oh, we got a torpedo here. Oh, too dark, can't launch. All right. All right, well, let's get through the night of day 14 here, see what we can come up with. Once again, Task Force 2 has something going on. I've got the radar and sonar on. I've got them turning to maneuver away from land. In the dark of night. Could be anything. They could have been more than one sub in that group there, but try and get our ships up to speed here. Where's Java going? Let's just break everybody off and start forming them up manually. Not really sure what to expect out of this one. Could very well be another submarine. Could be that surface group. Yeah, it's a submarine. Okay. Alright, we can deal with that. At least now we know where the track is coming from. Okay. Sumatra is in the... Well, all of our cruisers are basically in the worst possible spot here. Sumatra is probably in the best spot, or the Java is probably in the best spot to dodge. Let's get you turned. Yara, Borrego, you're going to lead the charge on the depth the attack. Hopefully we can dodge these torpedoes. All right, turn back in. Looks like we may be okay on this one. Let's slow you down. Gonna be close on that one there on the end, but... Yeah, it should be all right. Okay, slow down. Java and Houston are both in trouble. Let's slow down Warrego, Yara. Swan can barely move anyway, but... We'll slow her down too. Right, Houston. Oh, this is gonna be bad. We're gonna take a hit with the Houston. Unless we can get very lucky with this. Oh my god. Swing around. Not good. All right, slow down. Not sure what's going on with her. There we go. Okay, slow down, check the damages. Heavy damage, moderate flooding. Great, get those fires under control and then we could start working on 60% speed. That's not good. Alright, we're not picking anything up just yet. Let's get the Warrego up a little bit. It's brighter underwater than it is above. Zero percent integrity. Let's find this submarine. And we should have found him by now, I'd think. Slow down, see if you can pick them up. Looks like Houston has her damages fixed, at least what she can. Sure, we're gonna find this one. I think she'd be back in this area. We can look for her for a minute or two. Gave up looking. We may very well engage these guys again. Hopefully not, because Houston's kind of in a rough spot now. Exeter is on her way up, but... let's take a look here real quick and see. What we have to work with. March 28th, that's still a ways out. We've got quite a few, light cruisers coming in on the 28th of March, but that's still... quite a ways out. What we have here... York-class heavy cruiser, we got the Exeter. Would be it. There's the Langley. He's available. Kingfisher Scouts, two of them, and 8 PBY Catalina medium bombers. That actually might not be a bad idea to have some Catalinas. I mean, they're big and slow, but they do carry torpedoes, so we have to give that some thought. But we've got 7 days until we get more command points, and we're not getting a whole lot from anything that we're sinking here. That's how things are going in the Dutch East Indies on the 14th day of combat. I'm going to call this episode to a close here. I think I'm starting to run out of steam a little bit. So, anyway, if you guys like it, like the episode, hit the like button. If you have any thoughts, tips, or advice, leave that in the comment section below. If you'd like to follow along through the rest of the campaign, hit the subscribe button. I promise I am not always this cloudy of speech and mind. But it is what it is, and it is the end of episode number 12. So thank you very much for watching, and have yourself a very good day.